What if my OneDrive is too big for my hard disk? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right to the question I was asked. I have a Surface with limited storage. I want to keep data in OneDrive and not on my local drive unless I need it. I don't know how to arrange that. When I delete items from my computer, OneDrive seems to want to replace them. Is there any easy way to set it up so that doesn't happen? This is actually a relatively common scenario that I expect to become more and more common, particularly with Office 365 now giving you a terabyte of online storage, if not more, depending on how you use it. It's very common, and certainly it happens to me, where I actually have more data in my online cloud storage than I have room for on my hard disk. Fortunately, OneDrive has a couple of different ways to approach this problem. Let's have a look. So on my Windows 10 home machine, the first thing I'm going to do is open up the OneDrive folder on my machine. And you can see that I've got three different folders of my own in addition to a document and the personal vault. I also want to look at those folders in the cloud because there's an important distinction that's going to happen here. So I'm going over to OneDrive.com and we'll see there that I'm actually looking at the same information. If I instead look at a compact list, we'll see that it actually looks very similar to what I have up above. Now you can see that the article images folder down below has 5.5 gigabytes of information in it. Let's say that that's too much. And let's also say that I never, ever, ever use that folder or its contents on this particular machine. We're going to go over to OneDrive settings. I'm right clicking on the icon and I'm clicking on settings to bring up that dialog. In the account tab, which is the default tab, we're going to click on choose folders. Now you can see that all of these folders are visible. All these folders are available in my OneDrive folder on my PC. I'm going to uncheck article images. Now pay attention to this little message down here. If you stop syncing files or folders, they'll stay on OneDrive, but they won't be on this PC. If they're already on this PC, they'll be deleted. That is pretty much exactly what we want. We want those files to be in the cloud and not on that PC. I'm going to click OK. And you can see that in the File Explorer view, the article images folder disappeared. But you can also see that it is still present online in the cloud in the lower window. That is a wonderful way to manage disk space if you have things organized appropriately at the folder level. You can make entire folders disappear from specific PCs. If you take a look at that top view there in File Explorer, it's like that article images folder doesn't even exist in OneDrive. It does, of course, and we could go back to choose folders and turn it back on if we wanted to, but this is the only place that you would know on that PC that this folder exists. This is a great way to manage large amounts of data. You can basically say this for any folder. You can certainly go into subfolders if you like and turn them off specifically, but I like to do this at the top level wherever possible, simply because it gives me the greatest amount of space savings. So that's one approach to managing space. And as you can see here, it saves us at least 5.6 gigabytes. Those 5.6 gigabytes will not appear on the PC. Another approach is a feature called Files on Demand. Now that is over here in the Settings tab of the Settings dialog. You'll see that there is an option here called Files on Demand, Save Space, and Download Files as You Use Them. What I'm going to do is take a look inside of this transfer folder here. We're going to work on a couple of these individual files. It doesn't matter that they're small, the concept still applies. You'll notice that each has a status icon that is an outline of a cloud. What that means is the file is not physically present on this machine. the name is, the folder is, but the actual contents of the file have not yet been downloaded and is not yet taking up space on the machine. I'm going to right-click on this file and say always keep on this device. The file is then synced and downloaded. You'll notice that it's changed to a green checkmark. That green checkmark means that the file is A, present, and B, synchronized with what's in the cloud. If you were to double-click on the file to say run it or open it in its companion application or something else that requires the file's data to be downloaded, that would cause the file's data to be downloaded. Now, as you can imagine, for large files, that could take some time. You could double-click on, say, a very large document, and it would have to be downloaded before it can be opened in its application. That could add a little bit of extra time. But as you've seen here, we can simply right-click on the file and say that, yeah, I want this on my machine all the time. Let's say now that you've decided that this file is not something you need on your machine all the time. Well, you can uncheck always keep on this device. That means that the file is only downloaded when needed, and if you don't need it, you can clean it up. You can see that the actual status icon has changed to a check mark in a green circle, which means that the file is synced and is something that was downloaded only on demand. If I now say free up space, in other words, that's instructing OneDrive that for all of the files that are not always keep on this device, you can go ahead and remove the actual data. If we need it again later, we'll download it again later. So I'll say free up space. That icon changes once again back to the cloud icon with nothing in it. That is another approach. In fact, it's the default approach these days when you install OneDrive. It means that OneDrive could represent gigabytes and gigabytes of files in the cloud, but those files don't take up any space on your machine until they are actually used. Now, you can, if you like, do that at the directory level, at the folder level. If you'll notice that the transfer folder here also has that outline of a cloud icon. I can say on transfer to always keep on this device. You'll notice its icon changes. It now went to a green check mark. And if we go into it, we'll see that all of the files within that folder have been downloaded. Had there been subfolders, all of them would have been downloaded as well. So that's a great way to manage the amount of space that's being taken up with files that you really only need if you need them. You really only need to download them if, in fact, you need them for some reason. Now, there is another approach to this entire problem, and it's not something I'm going to show you here, but it is something that can be done. And that is simply that you can change the location of your OneDrive folder. The way to do that is to click on Unlink this PC. It will remove the OneDrive folder from your PC and everything in it, freeing up that space. Then you would be prompted to reconnect your OneDrive account. When you do that, you will have the option to change the location of the OneDrive folder. If you have multiple drives, as I believe this machine does, you can see I have a local disk C and a local disk G. I could, if I wanted to, tell OneDrive to move its folder to the G drive so that whatever we decide to do with OneDrive, it would take up space on that other internal drive. Now, this only works for internal drives. You can't do this with externals, but it is another way of managing your OneDrive disk space by having it be part of a different drive. Finally, OneDrive has what it calls backup, and this actually turns out to be a somewhat confusing feature because it can actually result in, well, at least the appearance of duplicate folders. I'm going to go ahead and say manage backup. Now, it currently has everything backed up. It's selecting my desktop, my documents, and my pictures. If I say start backup, those folders, whatever they happen to currently contain in Windows, will also be part of my OneDrive. which is fine. You can view the sync process, and you can see that, yep, there's all sorts of things that have synced. That's great. If I now go back to OneDrive Online, you'll see that there are a few additional folders in the online storage. There's my desktop. There's documents. Well, that was already there, but we're using it. And there's pictures. So these folders that are part of my desktop experience are now being backed up to my cloud online. If I go to my desktop, you'll see that there's a desktop.ini. That's actually these files over here. If I go to documents, you'll see that I have where are my files, a couple of different versions of that. Here's what's confusing. Notice that the path for the documents folder that we're looking at here is actually users, my username, OneDrive documents. I'm going to open up another instance of Windows File Explorer because what we'll see is that if I now explicitly go to /users/my username, there's another documents folder there. It's a different documents folder. And depending on which application you're using and how it has encoded the documents folder to use, it could be using either one of these. When you specify backing up with OneDrive, all of the Microsoft applications, not just OneDrive, but Word, Excel, all of the others, will end up starting to use this OneDrive documents folder. But other applications may not be so smart. So it is very much worth understanding that when you back up using OneDrive, which is a totally valid thing to do, you may end up with duplicate document folders and using one when you might think you're using the other. It's something to be aware of, and if you find yourself using the wrong one, you'll need to go into the application that happens to be doing it and change the location that it happens to be using as its default for documents, for photos, or potentially, though there are few, for your desktop. Now, I said lastly, but I lied, there is one other option, and that is there's nothing that says you actually have to have OneDrive installed on your machine. You can completely access OneDrive online only. So if I now unlink this PC, poof, OneDrive is no longer a part of my usage on this PC. None of the OneDrive files and folders are taking up any space. They've been removed. Everything still remains online. I can't access the documents that I care about by using them here. I can explicitly download them if I want to. I can do whatever it is I want to using the OneDrive online interface entirely without having OneDrive installed on the machine. I find it less useful because you don't get the benefits of automatic synchronization, but it is another approach that works really well for online access when you've got a real disk space crunch. I hope that was helpful. I hope that gives you some ideas of how to manage disk space in OneDrive. As always, the original article on which this video was based is askleo.com/129954. You'll find any updates, related links, comments, and more there. As always, thank you for watching. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Take care.